that to maintain,
our advocacy goal is simple, it's to maintain the Sixth Congressional District as a true North Shore district. It's been that way for some time, and we want to make sure that we maintain that to keep that kind of local representation to our district. But also remember that, sure, we have to add 76,000 seats, our people, but so does every other district, once you collapse one. And here's where the fun begins, because if you look at some of the border communities, if you will, to our district, if you went from north to south along the western border of our district, you'd see Haverhill at 61,000 people, and you'd continue down to Methuen and Lawrence and Andover, and you'd get down to the southernmost point, which is Chelsea. You see the populations, and you see to the right of the populations what congressional district they're in now, those communities are in now. But just take Lawrence, for example. If it seems the simple thing would be we need 76,000 people, there are 70,000 in Lawrence, that gets you 90% of the way there. But the minute you add Lawrence to the sixth, then the fifth goes from needing 76,000 or so people to 76,000 plus 70,014, so 160,000 people. So kind of, there's this ripple effect, of course, that occurs to it. This is now, as I said earlier, kind of where the fun begins. What's the process for redistricting and how can we impact it? And that's quite simple. The legislature has created a Massachusetts Joint Redistricting Committee. It has 28 members, 21 are House members, 7 are Senate members. Of that membership, just to give an idea of how the North Shore is represented. There's the membership. You see Senator Tarr, the minority leader in the Senate. You see Representative Jones, the minority leader in the House. Chairman Keenan and Brad Hill. So we're pretty well represented in that group, and they're with reps and senators that are pretty well engaged in this process and have been so far supportive, very, very supportive of making sure the 6th gets maintained as a North Shore district. It's kind of what is our argument for maintaining the district, and where and how do we make it? And the where is, again, simple. The first step for this, what we're all working on right now, what Bob and I and other people are working on, is the fact that on June 20th, the Massachusetts Joint Redistricting Committee, which is doing meetings across the Commonwealth, they're doing 13 regional meetings. Their goal was to have a regional meeting within a 45-minute drive of every voter in the Commonwealth. The North Shore meeting is June 20th. It's at 6 o'clock at Lynn City Hall. And it's our opportunity to make an impression, on the Joint Redistricting Committee that maintaining a true North Shore district is important to the region. And while our overall goal is to advocate for maintaining a North Shore district, our more immediate goal is to make an impression on June 20th that the North Shore cares. And what we're doing now, what we're all doing now, is working to gain some steam towards June 20th. There will be an inordinate amount of politics and infighting after June 20th. But between now and June 20th, our goal needs to be to make sure that when the Mass Redistricting Committee comes here, that we're ready and we show them that it's an important issue on the North Shore.